The recent exodus is just the latest in several waves of mass migration over the past four decades, and by most measures it is the worst. The Myanmar government has said about 400 people died during the renewed conflict. Bangladeshi officials claim the number of dead has exceeded 3,000. Countless others are now at risk of preventable deaths in refugee settlements and remote areas unreachable by humanitarian aid workers. The total number of Rohingya now sheltering in camps in Bangladesh has reached about 700,000, with new arrivals joining the hundreds of thousands who fled violence in previous years. The exact Rohingya population is unknown. The group was excluded from Myanmar's 2014 census, the country's first count in more than three decades, but the number of people displaced over the past 3 weeks alone could represent more than a third of the estimated 1.1 million believed to reside in Myanmar. Muslims in the state's north once lived peacefully with their Buddhist, Hindu, and other neighbors. Over the past half a century, however, the group has often become the target of nationalist propaganda campaigns claiming they are dangerous interlopers. Several waves of violent displacement sent many Muslims fleeing, while government housing projects relocated large groups of Buddhists into what were previously Muslim townships. The Rohingya saw their lives slowly transformed as schools, businesses, and health facilities became more segregated. The United Nations, Amnesty International, Human Rights Watch and other independent groups have documented decades of abuse and discriminatory public policy against the group amounting to persecution. The Myanmar government has consistently denied abuse and has cut off most humanitarian access. The government of Aung San Suu Kyi, the Nobel Peace Prize laureate and former dissident who last year became the country's de facto democratic leader, has come under harsh criticism for failing to stop or even speak out against the violence. Officials claim Rohingya militants are responsible for killing civilians, and that Rohingya have been setting their own houses on fire. Local reports suggest that militants have caused some of the deaths and destruction, but testimony indicates that the Myanmar military is the primary culprit. The Myanmar government should stop claiming that the Rohingyas are setting fire to their own homes and laying waste to their own villages, UN Rights Chief Zaid said Monday. This complete denial of reality is doing great damage to the international standing of a government which, until recently, benefited from immense goodwill. Bangladeshi Foreign Minister Abul Hassan Mahmud Ali briefed diplomats on the situation Monday, blaming the government of Myanmar for a policy of wiping them out of their land through a gradual and excruciating process. The country, which has not acceded to the UN Refugee Convention and does not provide legal status to these asylum seekers, has in the wake of the crisis suspended its prior policy of turning back refugees, letting most proceed across the border to safety while a smaller number remain in limbo at the border. The minister also called on the international community to support a controversial plan to temporarily resettle Rohingya refugees on Bashan Char, a remote island prone to cyclones and flooding. The US and the UN have both commended the Bangladeshi government's initial response to the crisis, urging the country to keep its borders open and calling on the international community to provide assistance for the refugees. The Bangladeshi Foreign Ministry has further urged Myanmar to immediately implement the recommendations of the Rohingya Commission, an independent advisory board chaired by former UN Chief Kofi Annan and established at the behest of Suu Kyi. The Commission's recommendations, which were made public only hours before the attacks that triggered the latest episode of violence, include creating a path to citizenship for the Rohingya, granting them freedom of movement, calibrating security responses with political intervention, and pursuing equitable socio-economic development throughout the state. The root of the Rohingya crisis lies in Myanmar, the Bangladesh Foreign Ministry said in a statement to diplomats. Therefore, the ultimate solution has to be found in Myanmar only.